Thank you. These were really great extensions. Hi, my name is Nick. I'm the product manager on the extensions project. And I'd like to tell you a little bit about the gallery that we launched yesterday. So first, let me close down some of these tabs. And I'm also going to head over and uninstall Aaron's extension. And not because I don't like it, but because I have a secret plan. So let me go ahead and do that. And now, let me go to our gallery. So, let's search for Gopher. We weren't lying. Here is Aaron's extension. It's getting pretty good ratings. So maybe I should report it as spam now for having a fake description. But actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and install it. And there we go. So I promise that this isn't because we had someone behind the scenes furiously approving this. Actually, we think that one of the great strengths of our gallery is that most approval for most extension is absolutely automatic. So you don't need to sit around for one of us to go and check on it. Now, of course, there's still extensions that might be abusive. And so if we receive a report about that, we'll go and take it down. Same thing if an extension violates our terms of service, we'll go and take it down. But the nice thing is you don't have to wait for us when you post your extension. You can just get it live right away. There are a couple of exceptions to this policy, namely extensions that use native code and extensions that access the file system. Now, for security purposes, we do send those to manual review. But this review is as simple as signing a copy of our terms and sending that in to us. We've seen very few extensions use this so far, which I think is a testament to the flexibility of the system already. And when those we have seen have gotten approved very, very quickly. So we think that this is really a big gain for developers. As you saw, you can write an extension in 5 minutes, you can get it up in a minute, and start distributing, start testing, start getting users. The second thing I'd like to tell you about today is a little bit about how to make your extension successful in the gallery. We think there are three things you can do to make your extension really do very well. First one, of course, is to build a great extension. The second one is to pay attention to how this extension shows up in the gallery. And then the last one is to promote that extension yourself. So let's go through those in order. Building a great extension, that one's pretty obvious. At Google, we're very focused on the user. We think that the products that best meet the needs of the user at the end of the day win. And we think the same applies for extensions. And in fact, we'll be tweaking our ranking algorithms and the extensions we feature to constantly try to give an edge to those extensions that are helping users to really browse the web and enjoy the web better. The second one, about making your appearance in the gallery as good as possible, I will illustrate with an example. So let me pull up an extension that I find particularly pretty here, which is the Glue extension. The Glue extension allows you to get social recommendations for movies, books, music, and other media. Now you'll notice that this looks a little bit different from Aaron's extension, which Aaron, I'm sure, will polish his up later on. You'll see that we've made it incredibly easy to actually make a very beautiful extension page. We let you add large screenshots, we let you add a description, and we even let you add YouTube videos. We think this last feature, adding a YouTube video, is going to be particularly useful for extensions, because it's often hard to explain exactly what an extension does without showing it in action. And you can do this right on your detail page. Another thing I'd like you to notice on this gallery page, on this detail page, is a little section here in the corner on the blue background. What you'll notice here is that they have a very nice, colorful logo, and they have a short description that very clearly states what their extension is going to do and doesn't, and actually avoids any kind of marketing speak. Now, the reason this is so important is that this information is what shows up in search results and as you browse through the gallery. And so this is really what the user bases their decision to click on your extension on. And by keeping this as clear as possible, that lets you stand out among a field of extensions. The last part of making your extension successful is to promote it. Now, of course, as a Chrome extensions team, we're going to do our very best to promote all the great extensions you write. So we have featured extensions, we have top picks, we're going to be doing blog posts, and many more things. But we also encourage all developers, such as yourselves, to go out and promote the extensions through the channels that you have available to you. One example of that that I think is great is promoting your Chrome extension to users of Chrome that visit your website. And what that does is gives you a starting user base. It lets you start rising in our rankings, and then that in turn makes us even more likely to want to showcase you. So we think if you do these three things, build a great extension, really polish its appearance in the gallery, and then start promoting it, then you'll have a really good chance at having success, and we think this is a really great opportunity. So let me also be clear that today, while not the first day of extensions, we've been working publicly for a while, it's the first day that we're out in the open for our beta users. But it's by no means the last day for extensions. We've got a lot of exciting things going forward. First obvious one is Mac support. In fact, extensions already work on the latest Chromium builds, so the latest open source builds of extensions, of Mac have extensions. And we expect that later this week, we will ship a dev build with extensions enabled on Mac. And then extensions will come to Mac on beta and in stable in early 2010. The second part is internationalization. Chrome is already available in more than 40 languages. And we have a lot of users internationally. And we want to make it just as easy for extension developers to reach our international users as it is for us. We hope that a lot of you will take advantage of this functionality, which, again, will be coming in Q1. Finally, we're going to be adding lots of APIs. I expect that for every subsequent major release of Chrome, we will have a new set of APIs for you to play with. Now, we have some ideas. We want to add more UI surfaces. We want to add, say, keyboard shortcuts, maybe some way to interact with network requests. But at the end of the day, we're looking for your feedback to tell us what you want and what's missing to create your next great idea. And as we're open source, just join us on the mailing list, submit an idea, submit a proposal, or even come help us implement it. So to finish, we've been out now one day. When we first launched, we had about 300 extensions. The last I checked, I think we were up to 480. We're hoping we can hit 500 by the end of today. Actually, we must be at 481 by now, at least. And so we've been really happy with the reception we've seen so far. As Brian mentioned at the beginning, we find extensions incredibly important to the future of Google Chrome. And we're hoping that if you're a user, you go out and try one of the many extensions we have available. And if you're a developer, you come up with your next awesome idea and build it for Chrome. Thank you. One last thing. Now you're, of course, welcome to grab something to drink and eat. We've also set up a few conference rooms around this area where the demoers, so Xmarks and eBay and Google Translate, will be around to showcase their extension and chat with you guys. So feel free to go find them. Also, all the extensions team members are here. We're wearing these shirts. Come find us. We're really excited to talk to you all. I'm gonna love you now. Love is love and not fading.